Jeff, I wanted to first thank you for being with me. Tell me about this design, because it's getting a lot of buzz in the marketplace.
Well, thanks. It's been great to be part of the DPharm this year.
Thank you.
So I appreciate the invitation. LungMap is really an innovative partnership that is a true collaboration between a number of different public and private partners. Its origin is really should be credited to the FDA, who through some of our work in meeting with them, acknowledged the pipeline of different products coming to market, at least through the testing phases in lung cancer, and acknowledged that in order to successfully accomplish these clinical trials, there's going to have to be a new way of doing things, because what we're seeing in lung cancer is that different populations are being defined based on molecular alterations and then drugs being targeted to those alterations. And it's shown in different types of cancers where this is particularly effective as a way of treating patients. So what LungMap does is essentially bring together a number of different biomarker-driven drugs within the same master protocol so that they can be efficiently tested, screening the patients up front with next-gen sequencing to determine the molecular makeup of their tumors, and using that information to shuttle them into the different arms that are currently available. One additional attribute to the study is having a non-match arm. So for patients that don't have one of the molecular alterations, an immunotherapy is made available to them. And we hope that this is a really great opportunity for patients to become involved in clinical research because of the higher likelihood that they'll qualify for one of these experimental arms.
But now, how did you make the collaboration work? Because there's a number of organizations involved. How did that happen?
I think the FDA was a huge driver in saying this is possible and we can't approve a drug that goes through this type of testing regimen. The NCI has been a huge collaborator along with all of the different academic institutions and the leaders in that sector that have really been a driving force behind developing the collaboration. We utilized the existing infrastructure of the oncology cooperative groups, the trials being led by the Southwest Oncology Group. And that has been a great way to get the trial up and running quickly. The trial went through the new centralized IRB at the NCI and is utilizing the National Clinical Trials Network, which is making this available in hundreds of sites across the country.
That's superb. Tell me about the challenges or some of the hurdles, because this is not an easy task by any stretch.
Right. Well, there's a lot of people involved, both from government, from academia, from industry, from many of the leading lung advocacy organizations that have really come together to do business differently. And that's what LungMap is about pushing the boundaries, about getting away from standard operating procedures for the benefit of the partnership. And that's sometimes difficult because each organization has their own timelines and their ways of doing business that really work for them for their day-to-day processes. But in LungMap, in some ways it's required folks to step away from those standard operating procedures and do things that will benefit the partnership ultimately.
As you know, this morning's session, the question that we ask is, what would it be like to do a clinical trial altogether? And so you're really leading the way for the industry.
I hope this is a good model that can be followed. There is interest in other cancer types and other diseases of trying to use this master protocol approach because of the efficiencies for time, for cost, and most importantly, for patient benefit.
Yeah. Jeff, thank you very much.
Thank you.